how do you think it's better to narrow down? To narrow down because I know you have to go small before you go big. So what's your experience with that?
So you are completely right. You absolutely have to, first of all, define that small thing that you're doing in order to build that foundation. Let me give you an example. I worked at a company called HealthTap back in 2010. It's still out there. It's essentially in the telemedicine space. Our first vertical was new moms and pregnant women. That's it. That's like a year and a half period of a woman's life. Very specific, well-defined group. We were able to launch to them, so we knew exactly what our audience was, what they loved, what they didn't love. And so we could make that messaging tight and clear for that particular audience. And so, and then they went big. And you know, now they cover every disease out there. You can take those same kind of lessons from Silicon Valley, where we start small, we start in a tiny little vertical, very clear messaging and language, and then expand. I'll give you an example from, say, the patient as CEO. Now you know it's all about you know, patient empowerment and technology. But within that, I actually give keynotes on AI, robotics, sensors, 3D printing, connectivity in the IoT, virtual healthcare, point of care diagnostics, virtual reality and drones. Oh, and tissue engineering. So like I literally have keynotes in each one of those verticals, but you're not going to think of that when you see my platform. You know it's going to be about technology and about patient empowerment. And that has not limited me. And that's the point I really want you to hit home. That has not limited me from giving keynotes on all of those other different subjects. Right? It's just having that clear foundational message out there so people can grasp what it is. And then the next step is to lay out your actual customer avatars. What I mean by customer avatar is in the world of marketing, you define your audience, your perfect audience guest, as, you know, what age range, what sex are they? Maybe they're both male and female. Are they married? What is their college status? Anything you can find out about your perfect customer avatar, or you can imagine, you're defining your audience right there. So